How long have you lived in Crenshaw?
Since 1975.
And how do you feel about the gentrification process in Crenshaw?
It ain't nothing but recolonization.
What do you think that Crenshaw is going to lose in this process of gentrification if it continues?
The country going to lose, always trying to eliminate us from progress, trying to get ahead, establish ourselves as who we are as a people. Somebody's always trying to put up stop signs, barriers, and roadblocks. They don't want us to have the green light of life. They're always interfering in our life. Let us have a life like you have a life. We don't interrupt your life. Well, our life got to always be interrupted. You gave up something, now you want to come back to it and kick us to the curb.
I moved to the Watts area, and we were there for like 13 years. And then I moved to the Crenshaw area.
They make a left down there at the corner. So the first thing I'm going to show you guys is how this, a lot of these developments are so out of harmony with the community. This legislation that came down from the state of California, that transit-oriented communities that I was talking about, has been a nightmare. Not just for our community, but for communities all over California, and it really is impacting everybody, you know what I mean? Except for developers. Developers are having the time of their life right now, you know what I mean? In terms of benefits, in terms of projects, is the money is flowing, you know, and they are, you know, coming in and building whatever they can get for the maximum dollar. So it has nothing to do with need, you know, right. It has strictly to do with greed.
Right.
They allow a developer that's anywhere within fourth to a half mile to come in and build up as high as is allowed. And in some cases, there is no way. If any of this property here goes up for sale, they can buy it, they can demolish it, and they can build up a lot higher, get a lot more money, push a lot more space into it. The housing that they are that they're allowed to build on, to build, it only meets the need for people who can, you know, for low income and low income, it's usually less than 10%, 11% or less. You know, so that'll be like they'll have like an 84-meter building, and five of them will be low income or low income. That gives them the right to come in and just build all this stuff.
Hope is a resident-driven organization that developed after the 1992 vote, and basically in response to addressing quality of life issues and also addressing the neglect that actually caused the revolt. You know, lack of community services, you know, lack of business services, you know, quality schools, you know, housing, all of the issues that affect quality of life.
We'll show you the artwork at the High Park Library.
All of it's good.
Okay, because the High Park Library, that is really a community. That was a community-focused project.
Now see, what this was, before it was a library, it was a recycling center. It was a ugly eyesore to the community for years. It had a little wire fence around it, and it had dirt that you ride up in the dirt, and it was just a mess. You know, we hated it. It was so ugly. When we found this site to replace our old library, the owner of this site then got some ideas that, okay, well, he could double benefit off of it. So he wanted to build a store at the bottom, have the library on top where he sold liquor. And the community vehemently protested, and they showed up at a community meeting. They had no idea. They didn't even expect the level of participation at that meeting. I mean, the room was packed. All the different elements of the community was there, and we won. It was a victory.
You can just start with introducing yourself, and yeah.
My name is Jabari Jumani. I am a long-term resident of South Los Angeles. I am a city employee, presently completing a career, or finishing a career, with the LA City Fire Department. I am also the director of the AFIBA Center in South Los Angeles. This is a community-based, cultural, African-centered institution in the South Los Angeles African-American community, which has, for the last 21 years, brought about programs to the community to help enhance the community in ways of social development, economic development, cultural education, and we've been pleased to do that for that period of time. As you know, right now we are under siege. We are under attack. There are the councilman, Marquise Harris Dawson, in the community has served an eviction notice to us in the effort to dismantle what we're doing at the center, close it down, shut it down, and be gone. We are fighting that addiction effort through many ways. Now, what do I see the future being? That has not stopped us from looking at expanding our program, and we're very excited about the programs we see coming up and taking the ones that we do have to another level. You have to be able to read between the lines. And when you read between the lines, we see that this project called Destination Crenshaw, the Councilman Marquise Harris Dawson has proposed and is promoting his Destination Crenshaw program, where you can now, they will put artwork up along the side, so anybody riding that rail system can see that this African-American art, that this is an African-American community, and, you know, this culture will not be erased. Yeah, that's a good aesthetic, but it's not substantive. And anybody who reads between the lines can tell that though it looks good to the untrained eye, to the trained eye, when you see this coming through and the potential for impending gentrification, and what you must do at that point is dig into this community and help solidify this space. In other words, what fights gentrification is the ownership of these residential properties, the ownership of these commercial properties. And when you beautify the community with a project like Destination Crenshaw, an art installation that makes people on the surface think one thing, it's not that at all. It attracts others to come into the community, which will have market rates of property go up, and individuals who live here will not be able to afford it, and they will be displaced.
The earth don't belong to you, dude. Why you keep acting like the earth is yours and you can dictate to everybody because you got this and you got that? You ain't God. You got a God complex, but you ain't God. There's a higher source than your money and your guns. And stop trying to be a bully with guns and laws that always favor your side. And when it comes to us raw black Africans, you always want us on the caboose while you be the engineer driver. We want to drive the train and own the train too, and lay the track for our future, for our children, so they can be engineers in life and go forward on the train of life.
Stop the rain.
I'll be right back. I got a customer.